Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergeist 5000 with a new, fresh LP. This is Cave Story. Maybe you could make the little audio a little bit louder. I don't know. Whatever, it doesn't really matter. I'm gonna play this. I'm just playing the original version, because this is the one I've played the most. From somewhere. A transmission. Oh, no. Executing chat algorithm. Sue? You there? It's me, Kazuma. I managed to get away somehow, but I've gotten lost. I found a shelter, but there's nothing here. If you can hear me, please answer. Please? Something about that always blew my mind. Just how, like... Because I've never had... I've never had to use a computer like that, where, like, I had to use code to execute programs or algorithms or whatever. I've only ever used Windows. So I always thought it was really weird. Like, blew my mind that he had to, like, I don't know, tell the computer with words to open the chat program or something. Anyway, we're running around here in this, what's this area called? First Cave, I think. Now, I should preface this LP with a warning, a disclaimer, as it were. I haven't beaten this game in at least 5 years, and I've never actually gotten the best ending either. So hopefully this will be something. Oh, a second transmission. Searching for user Sue. One user Sue found. Like, I feel like if I had been like into programming in the night, if I had been alive in like the 80s and 90s to be there for those early days of programming and internet usage, this would make a lot more sense to me. But Sue, please respond. They're looking for you. Are you asleep? Your brother is so lonely. It always confused me why you see those cutscenes, but it's actually just occurred to me that if I were to explain why you actually see those cutscenes, it would be like a pretty significant spoiler. Not that there's anybody watching this who doesn't already know Cave Story, probably. I don't know how big this game's demographic, like, of people who are familiar with it as an item in their reference pool. You know what I mean? Ow. Is that heart still there? No, not anymore. Be careful around these spikes, because these things do 7 damage, and I only have 6 health right now. So, 6 health max. I even lost one. I think they do 7 damage. They might actually do 10. You could tell me either one, and I would have to believe you. Okay, I might actually not progress through this door until I fight a couple more enemies, because the thing about weapons in this game is they can level up. They can level up 3 times, up from like 1, 2, 3, and then they get to max level. And I think most weapons in the game getting them to max level doesn't actually make a difference from 3. But Sue, answer me! I'm so hungry. There's nothing to eat, and I've been reduced to feeding on cockroaches. Haha, that was a joke. If I have to, though, I really will. And all of a sudden, there's rabbit people. Like, what's going on here? I'm confused. Hand over the key!
No, I won't!
Are you trying to protect Sue? She's a stranger. She's not one of us.
Sue's a good person. I'd never betray her.
Toroko, when the doctor comes, you know he'll take someone away again. If we don't turn Sue over, it might be you he takes instead.
But...
The key, Toroko!
Oot!
Shoot! I always remember the way she hops there before she falls off screen. So what's your deal? Mr. Bloodshot Eyes Man. What? You're not an enemy? I thought for sure it was them. I'm king. I'm the number one in this village. Not that that means a whole lot with only 6 of us left. Well, 7 counting Sue. She's not one of us, though. She's just an outsider who showed up recently. Okay, bye. Where am I going? Yeah, it's been a pretty long time since I've played all the way through this. I think I tried to LP this, like, a long time ago. like, not even that long of a time ago, like, just before, like, just since my reboot, I've tried to record this, but I think it lags too much with Bandicam. It might even be lagging now, I wouldn't know, because I haven't watched gameplay footage of this in so long. This feels right, like, it feels like I'm not lagging. Open the chest. Got the map system with circles around it for some reason. Something is written here. So long as you retain your spirit of exploration, surely you shall find your way out. This I believe. This quote, I don't know why, but this quote has really stuck with me, to the point that I had forgotten it was from this game until I just read it, like, in a little test recording. I thought it was from, like, Paper Mario or something, like, This I Believe, or, like, an Earthbound. No, I thought it was from Earthbound or Mother 3. Just, like, surely you shall find your way out, This I Believe. That just stuck so clearly in my head. The location of the Ringmaster's head. Now that shack down in the lower right is like kind of where the next story beat happens, but I tried going in there in the test recording and it didn't do the thing, so I think I have to talk to somebody out here.
Oh, you startled me. Sue? Oh, right. The girl in Arthur's house, right? She's living with Toroko. Sweet girl, that. Says she's searching for a sky dragon. Dragons that soar the skies. Do those kind of things really exist?
Oh, I don't fucking know. I just woke up in a cave, like, 5 minutes ago. The hell do you think? Who do you think I am? I think you have to talk to this guy first. He says, hello. I'm Jack, the number two around here. The door leads to the Mimicker graveyard where the hero Arthur lies. Oh, what am I doing, you ask? Well, mushrooms have been springing up in the graveyard, so I'm guarding the door to make sure they don't get out. Okay. Mushrooms. So you're making sure the mushrooms don't get out. Fireplace. Crackle, snap! You see something lying beyond the flames. Oh, I can't get to it, though. Oh, man, it's been a long time since I've played this. And, like, the music is, like, bringing back memories and shit. Yamashita Farm. This area... This is, like, another area that's really stuck with me for some reason, because of this area over here. There's an area in Super Metroid, in Meridia, that reminds me of this little drop right here with this little bit of water in a life capsule. And it reminds me of this area so much in Super Metroid, that area in Super Metroid reminds me of this farm so much, that every time I get to that point, I expect there to be something in that hole because of the life capsule that's here. I don't know why, like, those specific things stick with you. This is our farm. We raise flowers here. My job is to watch over the farm. We Mimikas depend on these flowers for sustenance. Red flowers, though, are bad news. If you eat a red flower, they say your blood starts to boil and soon you fall over dead. Good thing we don't have any of those growing here. Yeah, sure enough, Hoss. Sounds like a nightmare. Sounds like a true blue nightmare. Okay, do I have to talk to King again? Does it have to feel good to run again? Blast that Toroko! She ran out somewhere when you fell. Dawn, fiery mad. Do I have to come in here? Into the reservoir? Oh, dang it. Ah, dang it. Ha! There we go. Aww, I gotta get a running start first. You know, considering how loosey-goosey and, like, momentum-heavy and swingy the movement feels in this game, it's actually, like, surprisingly built for precision, and the entire game is built around, like, There's multiple places where I have to make really precise jumps. Yeah, I know her. That's the cute girl who stays cooped up in Arthur's house all the time, right? She showed up here not too long ago. We found her washed up right here in the reservoir. She doesn't seem to like us much. I don't know why, since she's a baby cat just like us. Just down here, something gleams in the dirt. Got the silver locket!
Fish! Fish!
Got a fish there. I'm not sure what that guy's called, but I think he's actually, like, mimetic in some circles of the Cave Story fandom for being, like, hilariously useless as an enemy.
Ah!
What are you doing here? Okay, that's what I had to do. I thought you had to do that after you go to the shack in the bottom right.
Give me the key!
No! I didn't find a rod, I found a key!
A key! Oh shit, I have a bag of Milky Ways! Grrr! Toroko! You're not getting away that easily!
You're not getting away that easy!
Man. He just had to say that because that reminds me of Star Fox 64, which was the other game I was considering LPing after Celeste.
Why you?
What? Oh man! You knocked my gun down! Can I go? It won't open. What? Okay, that's weird.
Eek! Save me, save me!
Huh? You're not with the doctor? Oh, I'm sorry. You had me worried. The doctor's such a mean guy. Popping up on our village and taking us away, sometimes even killing us. Like my brother. He killed my brother. Oh, that pendant. You found it for me. Sue gave that to me. Well, I shouldn't have it anymore. King gets his ears all in a tangle when he sees me and Sue, when he sees Sue and I getting along. You can have it. What? What?
Huzzah! There you are! You can't hide! No, no! I've got the nose of a bloodhound!
Indeed you do.
This guy is like a perfect character to go
The nose, and I dare say the brain as well.
Misery! I found her first!
You guys are with the doctor, aren't you?
So you're Sue, eh? The doctor has called for you. Come along now. What? I'm not Sue.
Oh no, she got her in a bubble.
Ah!
Balrog, I leave the rest to you.
No, wait! You got the wrong...
Not again! I always have to clean up! And here I found her first!
So what do you? So what's your deal? Are you gonna fight me with that thing?
It's funny, you can actually say no here and he just leaves.
I knew it!
And he's so happy, he's running back and forth like a goober. Look at this guy. Look at this toaster. Apparently he's actually supposed to be a bar of soap. Like, that's what he was designed after, was a bar of soap. But just look at his hands. That just screams toaster.
Oh, jeez.
Oh.
His own.
Just you wait!
Fought off Balrog. And you get a little bit of experience for beating him, so that brings back, up to level 2, which is nice. Oh, oops, that's... I jumped the gun a bit on the melody coming in. Okay, so now that that's done, I think now we can go talk to Jack and he'll move. This whole game is just like flags, flags, flags. Flaggy, flaggy, flaggy. Even the path of the true ending is flaggy. I mean, of course it is. Event flags are how you make games. That's how game progression progresses. What? Taroko's been kidnapped? Oh no! I've got to tell King right away!
I love how he's always got finger guns. Like, what is that?
And now he can come in here to the graveyard. I don't know if there's anything here. There's mush. There's some mush. Guys, you honestly told me that you guys couldn't kick the ass of a few mushrooms? And you got a gravekeeper here. I'm not sure what this guy's deal even is. Like, there's like this random gravekeeper with a knife. He doesn't look like any other character in the game. Like, who is that guy? Arthur's grave. There's writing on the tombstone. Here sleeps the noble Arthur, true hero of the Migas. Found Arthur's key. Alright, that's all you can do in the graveyard for now. You might have noticed there's a door up in the upper right corner. You can actually get in there later, but that's way later. What's in here? What's in here? Oh, it's you two.
Taroko, I can't believe it. Taroko's elder brother Arthur was a fabulous warrior, but he was killed by one of the doctor's goons. And now I couldn't protect her. Fuck.
There are two keys to Arthur's house. Taroko has one of them. The other is hidden in the Yes, it's hidden in the Go look in the Let's save. Because, like, I haven't saved since I started the game. Every time I think about composing my own music, I think of what Pixel said about composing music in this game, which is that he didn't really have any de facto experience or learning or education in music composition. He just put notes together until he got something that sounded good. It's like, man, I wish that was that easy for me. It drives me crazy putting random notes down, putting random notes down. I'm gonna save again, because I don't want to have to make that walk again. I don't want to have to run again. Words light up the screen. If I have to, though, I really will. Oh, that's so freaking cool, because it's like, oh man, the computer was right here the whole time that cutscene was going on, and you know, somebody might have been in here looking at that and not responding, or maybe some, or nobody was there, and it's just like the image of somebody messaging somebody, and then the other side of the messenger is like just a computer in a dark room that nobody's looking at, but the words are still popping up on screen. That's scary or something. Anyway, I feel like this might actually be a good place to end the first episode. Kind of a short dick video, but... See you guys next time, guys. See you guys next time, guys. We'll head to the egg corridor. Whatever that is, right? Stop. Bye.